Hello guys, in this tutorial we will discuss about the sort function for doubly linked list. All instructions are as previous. One new function void sort is included here to sort the data on doubly linked list. First we create the doubly linked list by using create option, that is option 1. Suppose our created doubly linked list is this one in right window. At 100 node number, at 100 location the data is 15, at 400 10, 300 400 5, and at 500 it is 12. Here 4 nodes are used. So we will move to the sort function. When we select the option number 8, it will show the current doubly linked list before sorting. 15, 10, 405 and 12 in left to right direction. In right to left direction it will show 12, 405, 10 and 15. The variables are used for this sort functions are shown here. Opt to select the sorting option. S and T are the global pointer variable to store the address of node. One new node is created here, Q. First we store the address of starting node in T, and we check the data on T with other data of nodes. So we compare 15 with 10. If 15 is greater than 10, then we swap these two, then the new value of this first node becomes 10 and this becomes 15. This 10 is again compared with third node and so on. After first iteration we move to the second node, that is at 400, and we check the data of this node with the next node and so on. The complete operations are shown in this program. First we created a new node Q. Temp is used to store the data for swapping. The list before sorting, display 2 will display the previous data. This is shown here in middle window. Since this list starts at 100, so the starting address of S becomes 100, and due to this instruction we store the value of S in T, so the T value becomes 100 and TN is 400. This is shown here, and TD is 15. Then we execute the outer while loop. Tn is not equal to null. Here Tn is 400, it is not equal to null, so we execute the outer loop. Then we store the Tn value in Q. Tn value 400, it is stored here, and 400 data is 10, 400 next is 300. This is shown in right window. Here, pointer T is stored the address of nth node, then pointer Q is stored the n plus 1th node address. After storing the Tn value in Q, we execute the inner while loop. We check here Q is not null or not. Here Q is 400. 400 is not null, so we execute the instructions of inner while loop. We check the if condition whether TD is greater than QD or not. Here TD is 15 and QD is 10. 15 is greater than 10, so we swap these two values by using third variable temp. This is shown here. We store the TD value in temp. TD is 15. This 15 is stored in temp. Then QD value is stored at TD. QD is 10. So this is stored here in TD. And then we store the temp value in QD. Temp value in QD. The result of this operations is shown in the next doubly linked list. This 10 comes here and this 15 comes here. We swap the 15 and 10 for ascending order. Then we move the Qn value in Q. Here Qn is 300. So this 300 is stored at Q. This is shown here. And the data at 300 is 405, and next address of 300 is 500. It is shown here. Then we again check the inner loop whether Q is not null. Here Q is 300, which is not null, so we again execute the if statement of inner while loop. TD is greater than QD. Here TD is 10 and QD is 12, which is not greater, so this if condition fails. So we only store the next address in Q. The next address of Q is 500. This 500 is stored at Q, and we again check the inner while loop. 500, Q is 500 and its data at this location is 12, and the next value is null. This is shown here. Then we again check the inner while loop Q. Q is 500. 500 and its data is 12. Next is null. Q is not null. So we again check the value of TD and QD. Now TD is 10 and QD is 12. So this condition fails, and we again store the Qn value in Q. Now Qn value is null, so this Qn value is stored here. Then we move out from the inner while loop and we store the address of next T, Tn, in T. Currently Tn is 400. So this 400 is stored at T. Then we come to the outer while loop and we check the Tn value. Now at 400, the next value is 300 and data is 15. and the data is 50. Check the condition. Here TN is 300, which is not null. So we store the TN value in Q. TN is 300. This is stored at Q. Then we again check the inner while loop whether Q is null or not. Here Q is 300 and its next value, its data is 405 and next value is 500. This is shown here. We check the inner loop. Q is 300, which is not null. So we check the if condition, TD is greater than QD. Now TD is 15 and QD is 405, so this condition fails. We come out from the if statement and again execute this instruction. We store the Q1 value in Q. Now Q1 value is null, so we store it in Q. We check the inner loop. Q is not null, so this inner loop fails and we again store the TN value in T. TN value 300 is. Sorry, one step skipped here. Current value is 300. The current Q value is 300. So 300 is not null. We check the if condition. QD 15 is greater than 12. Yes. So we store the TD value in temp. TD is 15 stored here in temp. Then QD value in TD. QD is 12, so it is stored here, and then temp value is stored in QD, that is this value is stored here. After swapping the 15 and 12, we get this doubly linked list. Then we store the Q1 value in Q. Q1 is null, so it is stored at null, and we check the inner while loop. This condition fails, so we come out from the inner while loop. Then we store the TN value in T. Here TN value is 300. This 300 is stored at T, and the next node of 300 is, next node of 300 has 500, it is shown here, and the data on 300 is 405. Then we check the outer while loop. TN is null or not. Here TN is 500, which is not null. So we store the TN value in Q. TN is 500, so it is stored at Q. The data at 500 now is 15, and the next address at 500 is null. This is shown here. Then we check the value of Q. Q is 500. Which is not null, so we execute the if statement. We check the condition TD. TD is 405 and QD is 15. 405 is greater than 15, so we store the TD value at 10. TD is 405, it is stored here. then QD is stored at TT. QD is 15, it is stored here in TD. Then we store the temp value in QD. 405 is stored at this location. After swapping these two value, 405 and 15, we get the new doubly linked list. This is shown here. 15 comes here and 405 comes here. Then we store the value of Qn in Q. Now Qn is null, so we stored it at Q and we check the inner loop. Now Q is null, so this condition fails. We come out from the inner while loop and then we store the Tn value in T. Tn is 500, so this 500 is stored at T and we check the outer while loop. Tn is null, this condition fails, so we come out from this outer loop and we show the message list after sorting. This is shown in middle window and due to this display too, it will display the message data on list in forward direction 10 12 15 405. This is shown in middle window and in reverse direction 405 15 12 10. 405 15 12 10. Thus the data is sorted. Thank you.